Water can't be liquid and ice at the same time. It doesn't make any sense. But here's the problem. Teams and companies need both phases at the same time. They need the Loonshot phase of radical innovation, and they need the franchise phase of operational excellence. So how can they do it? Well, there's one exception to the rule that matter can't be in two phases at once. Right on the edge of a phase transition at 32 degrees Fahrenheit. I want you to imagine a bathtub, and when you bring a bathtub of water to 32 degrees, two things will happen. Blocks of ice will form separately from pools of water. The two states will coexist, but they don't just sit there. The solid and the liquid are in what's called dynamic equilibrium. There's a constant exchange back and forth. Molecules swimming along in the pool of water will hit a surface of ice and freeze. Molecules on the surface of the ice will jiggle loose and join a pool of water. There's a constant exchange back and forth. And that's the secret to how companies can achieve both radical innovation and operational excellence, those two principles. Let's call the creative scientists or engineers or designers working on radical, high-risk, early-stage ideas, let's call them artists. And let's call the marketers or business people or producers soldiers. You need both. You want to separate your artists and your soldiers and create separate environments, artists and soldiers, each of those environments tailored for the different needs, their different styles and the different incentives that motivate them. That's one point. A lot of companies figure that out. They create these innovation labs. But they miss something just as important, if not more, which is the second point, which is called in science dynamic equilibrium, the constant exchange. That's the transfer between the two groups, not just in one direction when artists present their beautiful ideas or for the soldiers to take into the field, but in the other direction as well. No idea works perfectly the first time. If the soldiers don't bring back honest feedback from the field, customers won't use it, soldiers will stop selling it, and the idea will just die. For example, during World War II, the greatest threat to the Allied victory was the German U-boats, the submarines that were sinking Allied ships in the Atlantic Ocean faster than the Allies could build new ones. In 1942, a group of scientists quarantined in a secret building at MIT developed the technology that could allow pilots flying over the ocean to spot the U-boats and sink them. The scientists celebrated. They stood on top of a building in Boston and proved that they could detect a U-boat in the Boston Harbor. They gave their technology proudly to the Air Force, and nothing happened. The technology worked, but the pilots just weren't using it. Eventually, the guy in charge, an engineer named Vannevar Bush, was President Roosevelt's chief science advisor, told the scientists, the artists, the creative artists, to get in the cockpit with the pilots, the soldiers, and figure out what was going on. The scientists discovered that in the heat of the battle, pilots are sitting there, there are people shooting at them, they're flying hundreds of miles an hour. They didn't have time to fiddle with all the complicated switches, you know, the dozens of switches on the early radar boxes. The scientists realized that the technology was good, but the user interface was lousy. So they went back into the lab and they created a custom display, the sweeping line and moving dots we all see in the movies called a PPI display. Just like that, pilots started using radar, which turned the course of the war within a matter of a few weeks. So what's the lesson here? The weak link in the chain of innovation is not in the supply of new ideas, it's in the transfer to the field, which means you should spend your time less focused on the details of any one idea and more focus on the transfer, that dynamic equilibrium, the exchange not just one way, but in both directions, between artists and soldiers.